pauses and all the little kind of things. There'll be details and patterns here, so we'll see her do a bit of that.
I couldn't wait to play Amanda. I just couldn't wait because I realized I have sort of a responsibility as a Southern woman who knew those women.
You know, the way she talked, she was just as Southern as anybody's ever been, you know.
Called the Homemaker's Companion.
The purity of Glass Menagerie just his pure essence went into that play.
Oh no, honey, don't let them burn. You go take a look at the oven now, hold on.
I mean, there's so many beautiful moments to find.
Well, that woman, do you know what she did? She hung up on me.
And different things pop up and happen all the time, especially when you're working with actors who are as good as these people are.
It's been a real ride being the only Brit coming in to play, to do an American classic with incredible American actors. And Cherry Jones is just this incredible, genuine article, you know, seeing them interact. I mean, that's really thrilling to watch.
What in the hell am I supposed to do?
Don't talk to me like that. What is the matter with you? Have you gone out of your senses?
My poor little fella, he must feel sort of lonesome.
Boy, favorite moment of this play. Gosh, all right. Every time Michael Esper's on stage.
So, every time you come in the morning with that screaming, that bloody rise and shine, I think to myself how lucky dead people are, but I get up and I go.
John talks about all those characters being kind of unicorns. We're all kind of, yeah.
Mother calls it the Glass Menagerie.
You know, where we're at right now in the process, it's sort of every time we work on something, there's like a new moment that kind of hits you and that becomes exciting. And for that moment, there's, you know, a feeling of, oh my God, this is the most amazing thing.
And we just let the play happen to you and let myself sort of daydream about it, see who you become living with it.
Glass Menagerie now has become my favorite play ever. There is a perfection to it. And the way that John and Bob Crowley and Stephen Hoggett have visualized and brought to life, what their work is pure poetry, as is Tennessee's. And it just makes you feel it in a way in your heart and soul. But it affects so many people so deeply, this play.
So he is so-